What's up, everybody? Nice to see you here. Welcome to the channel. Today, for the first time, I'm checking out Through the Wire of Kanye West. Little contest, don't go away. I've been watching the documentary. I'm in two episodes, and I have to say, I don't know much about Kanye West apart from, you know, the stardom figure, the marriage to another, the best influencer in the world, you know, that kind of stuff. Of course, it's almost impossible not to be subjected to some of that in one way or another, but I really know close to nothing about his music. And of course, by watching the documentary, I have to say, honestly, I agree on two things. The first one was, rest her soul, the mother saying, you come across sometimes a little bit arrogant, and that's a little bit what I know about this character, you know, self-proclaimed genius. And of course, it's always strange when you don't know an artist and you only see those things floating around, right? It goes like, who is this guy, you know, like. But by watching the documentary, I have to say, I am truly inspired. I'm truly inspired. It really piqued my curiosity, this character, especially the young Kanye. And if anything, it opened up the door to appreciation, really, to this guy, at least his personal life. So I'm really curious, really, really curious. I know the hook of the song because it shows in the documentary, but I really know nothing about the first album. And before reviewing the new album, I thought to myself, let's check this out, shall we? So let's go, and bam. Really interesting, really, really interesting guy. And if anything, you really have to appreciate the perseverance, the motivation this guy had to just go where he wanted to go, really. I mean,
okay, can I get some change?
Yo, Chief, they can't stop me from rapping, can they? Kenny Hop. I spit it through the wire, man. There's too much stuff on my heart right now, man. I gladly risk it all right now. It's a life or death situation, man. Y'all don't really understand how I feel right now, man.
No insurance. Boy Kanye took. God damn it, seriously? Oh man, that was not a good, maybe at the time was a little bit cheaper than probably nowadays.
Shutdown, what's going on? I drink a boost for breakfast, an insure for dessert. Somebody order pancakes, I just sip the scissor. That right there could drive a sane man berserk. Not to worry, Mr. Ace to the Illos back to Wizard. How do you console my mom? Or give her light support. Telling her son's own life support. And just imagine how my girl feel. On the plane, scared as hell that a guy looked like Emmett Till. She was with me before the deal. She been trying to be mine. She a Delta, so she been throwing that dynasty sign. No use me trying to be lying. I've been trying to be signed, trying to be a millionaire. How I used to life
trying lines. To be signed. Yeah, we know the story now. Also, it's really fascinating also to hear this sound that seems much more placed in the 90s that of course what we are used nowadays with trap music. I'm not an expert, of course, by any means about rap music. I have a taste that is 360 degrees when it comes to composing music and all kinds of music in general. So I find it fascinating that this sounds much more kind of old school, I would say, nowadays, right?
In the same hospital with Biggie
Smalls. I actually like it. It's like pretty out of tune.
But I ain't Jamaican, man. Story on MTV, and I ain't trying to make a band. I swear this right here, history in the making, man.
Good guy, man.
I really apologize to everyone right now. Unclear at all, man. They got my mouth wired shut, like, I don't know, exactly shit, like, six.
You make me want to get in an accident. Round about my broke arm. Without an arm, I spit. Without an arm, I spit. Without an arm, I spit.
I'm really loving the documentary. Actually, later, I can't wait to see the third episode. Really, really fascinating. Also, the story of the friend, cinematographer, videographer. So what a great idea. And also what kind of fortune to have a friend that it's been taping you for that long and has all this material on you. And then ends up that you are actually that guy that becomes this famous, you know, like it seems so well done, you know, so in purpose in a way, so lucky also. And again, I think nowadays, of course, there's always an effect of fame on the ego. And sometimes people probably get a little bit off the hook, you know, in terms of like, I mean, off the rail, I meant when it comes to that. So they kind of inflate perhaps their personality even further because you're supported by all your achievements, you know, the Grammys and the great videos and the cultural impact. So that I assume it might have a little bit of an effect on the ego of someone, and it might take a lot of introspection to keep that at bay, maybe.
I'm still here for y'all right now, man. This is what I got to say right here, though.
Yeah, turn me up, yeah. What if somebody from the shadow was ill, got a deal on the hottest rap label around? But he wasn't talking about coke and birds, it was more like spoken word. Except he's really putting it down. And he explained the story about how blacks came from glory and what we need to do in a game. Good dude, bad night, right place, wrong time, in the blink of an eye, his whole life changed. If you could feel how my face felt, you would know how Mace felt. Thank God I ain't too cool for the safe belt. Swear to God, drive a 2-1-2. I got a lawyer for the case to keep us in my safe. My dogs couldn't tell if I look like Tom Cruise on Vanilla Sky.
It was Tom Cruise on Vanilla Sky. I love that, man. I like this guy, really. I'm really enjoying this guy much, much more. On another video, I'm going to share you an added anecdote about Kanye West. But I first want to kind of, I'm curious about checking some more music. I wonder, because one time I checked it and the first thing I heard of this song was like basically a loop of 21st Century Schizo Man, which is from King Crimson, a prog rock band from, I guess, 60s, 70s. And also, I love that band. I've been listening to King Crimson's a lot in the past. So when I heard that, I was like, like using loops of great bands. But then again, this is the whole point also, this type of music. There is a lot of aids of loops and parts taken from other songs. And I think also this song had some issues with Chaka Khan or something. There is a part of this song which had to be cleared in terms, I guess, of copyright so that it could be used. But obviously, in the sense of traditional musicians, a lot of people have some, let's say, like issues with some of those artists because they just shuffle together things of other people, you know. Also on this song, there's a lot of other artists. I think the voices, of course, are modified by a choir, or there's other things going on, you know, taken from other songs. But honestly, like I said, I've always been pretty open about music. And I think it takes a remarkable hear and vision to put it together in the right way, you know. So to that extent, you have to give credit to some of those artists to be more originals than other in using this type of technique to put together a song, you know. And of course, the rap flow is impeccable. This guy is a great rapper. There is no doubt about that.
Televised. Been an accident like Geico. They thought I was burned up like Pepsi did Michael. I must got an angel, cause look how death missed his ass. Unbreakable, what you thought, they call me Mr. Glass. Look back on my life like the ghost of Christmas past. Toys R Us where I used to spend that Christmas cash. And I still won't grow up, I'm a grown ass kid. Swear I should be locked up for stupid
Man, the mother of this guy, rest her soul, the mother of this guy, she was a freaking angel, the mother of this guy. Rest in peace. Really, what a wonderful person.
A champion, so I turn tragedy to triumph. Yeah. Make music that's fire. Yeah. Hit my soul through the wire. Woo.
You know what I'm saying? When the doctor told me I was gonna have a plate in my chin. I said, dog, did you realize I'm never making on a plane now?
It's funny because I hear this loop of this very high-pitched voice in a kind of childish way, and it's that kind of, I don't know, lofi music that you hear a lot in Casey Neistat vlog, so it's kind of funny.
Bad enough I got all this jewelry on. She can't be serious, man. We'll be right back.
What a journey this guy, man. Man, also shout out to Jay-Z in a way that I think he really saw like further away, you know, he really probably saw the guy and understood, you know. Yeah, amazing. Like, you also have to be surrounded by people that support you and people that give you a chance. What a thing. Can you imagine if they hadn't given him a chance to be on some of those albums, on the album of Jay-Z, and they would have just pushed him back in the position of a producer, you know, like just doing stuff for other people more. It's really a combination of stuff. And again, especially for us that we live outside the US, you also look at this or those story, and on top of everything, on top of the talent, on top of the persistence, on top of the resilience, on top of just the motivation and all of that, you also see, especially we coming from the outside, go like, you're also so lucky that this happened in the United States. You know what I mean? Because it might not never have happened anywhere else, or in another country, you know, maybe in a smaller measure, but the United States, in my opinion, of course you might not agree with that, but I think it's still one of the greatest country for this, and also to become this big. I don't think there is an equal, honestly. Congratulations. Guys, I'm really... Hey, check. Look at him, young guy. He already knew. Look at that, like dialing in the look, huh? Dialing in the look. So guys, I really enjoyed this. More old school. Absolutely a surprise. I mean, not 100% because I knew the hook of the song. I watched in the documentary, but now watching it, that entire video, knowing the documentary, then you realize also that the video itself, it's a little bit like a condensed, at least first part documentary, and you understand the references where they took the footage of, and in itself it's already an interesting story, and therefore that's why I probably won so many prizes. Thrilled to find out more. If you want to see more Kanye West first time, I'm right here. And let's do something else and then get to the new album, for perhaps, if you want to. Go check the other videos. My channel, there is plenty. A lot of Brazilian artists. Artists from Mexico, Argentina, Indonesia, everywhere around the world. So also my own cover of music. I talk to you later. Stay healthy. Stay creative and keep going. Never give up.